Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Sennappa. So this video we are going to discuss about packageac units and packageac units control panels. Okay, so nowadays ACs are very popular, that everywhere we are using ACs. Okay, nowadays some people they cannot live even without ACs. So ACs are available in different ratings. Okay, so from smaller to big sizes AC. Okay, so if you take any houses, so we will use small speak type AC. Okay, so if you go any shopping malls or biggest offices areas, they use centralized AC. Okay, so in between, so not smaller or not bigger. Okay, so in between there is some range. Okay, so that type of AC is called package AC units. Okay, so normally the split AC units available till maximum 5 tons. Okay, and the centralized ACs, it is available I think above 20 tons. Okay, so in between from 5 ton to 20 ton, the AC is coming with the ACs are called package units. Okay, so that is also AC. What is different between this split ACs and this package ACs and the centralized ACs, we will see now. Okay, so we used to see, we have seen many ACs in used in our houses. It is split AC unit. Okay, so where the small fan unit is installed inside the room and the outdoor unit, compressor unit, is installed somewhere outside the area. Okay, so the air will be circulated from our room, so the outdoor unit, from outdoor unit the cooled liquid will flow through the cooling coil inside the fan unit. So when the air circulating, the room get cooled. Okay, so this is split AC. And the centralized AC, it has also two parts. Okay, one is AHU, air handling unit, the bigger one with the blower motor, and the condensing unit. Okay, so somewhere we use condensing unit, somewhere we use chiller units. Okay, so this is centralized AC. But the package AC is coming with AHU and the condensing unit with one set, one package. Okay, AHU and compressor, evaporator, fans, everything housed in single unit. It's called package AC units. Okay, so this kind of AC is normally used in the medium range projects, like small shopping malls, medium range shopping malls. It is bigger than the split AC and smaller than the centralized ACs. Okay, so I hope you got this idea. So what is package units? So this package unit is coming with the all together in one AC, so it's called package unit. Okay, but split AC is coming with fan unit, fan coil unit separate, and the outdoor unit separate, and also centralized AC is the same. So this type of package AC units used in widely globe wise. Okay, so what is the benefit of this package units? We need how it is working, we will see now. Okay, the benefits of package units, like you can install this unit completely outside. Okay, so if you take normal AC, you need to install this fan unit inside the room or inside the area which will occupy your area. But this this package AC is okay, you can completely install outside, and you can provide the ducts. Okay, supply air and return air ducts. Okay, so within this the package unit will work, and it will fulfill your requirement. Okay. Okay, so this package ACs are actually, this package units are used for cooling as well as warming. Okay, so where the countries, like hottest countries, we use this package air conditioner. Okay, so in coldest area, okay, there are some coldest countries also available there, they are using this package units for warming the air. Okay, so this is different type. Okay, now we are discussing about air conditioner, like cooling type air package unit only. Okay, so in the cooling type package units, there are commonly two types are available. Okay, one is air cooled package units, another one is water cooled package units. Okay, So this air cooled package units are mostly used in the area, like this is a common one people are using mostly. Okay, so these package units same like other ACs only. Okay, it has all the parts like main air blower, condensing unit, evaporator fan, so small control panel inbuilt with, so it's complete one set. Okay, it will be size wise based on the capacity. Okay, from 510 to 2010 the sizes will be vary. Okay, so now we will see how we can see AC. Commonly everyone knows, the HVAC people knows how the ACs are working. Okay, so we are not going into that. Now we will see how we can control this package AC units. Okay, so normally to control this package units, these package units are coming without some package units based on the requirement. Okay, so it comes with the inbuilt thermostat. Commonly package units are coming with the provision of the external thermostat. Okay, once you purchase these AC units, you can install and you can do all your ducting. To control the package units, you have to provide external control panel or thermostat. Okay, so you have to control the package unit based on the temperature. Like once the package unit started, so it will start the cooling your area where you provided the duct, supply air duct and the return duct. Between that area, this the package AC will start cool. Okay, so we have to measure that particular area temperature and we have to control the package AC. Okay, to start stuff like once you start this package ACs, so the fan will be keep on running, that will flow the air through the cooling coil. Okay, so once this temperature we will set the temperature, so we want to maintain certain temperature, 21 or 22 or even 18 17. Okay, once the that set temperature achieved, the compressor should off. Okay, the or else this will keep on running and it will freeze the area maybe. Okay, so we have to control the compressor based on our setting temperature. For control the compressor based on the temperature, we need thermostat or external control panel. Okay, so now we have control panel for controlling the package ACs. Okay, so our control panel will control two package units based on the requirement, like duty standby. Okay, we need to run the package ACs continuously. Okay, so one unit is not enough because the one unit will keep on running till all over the year. There is a chance that the unit get damaged quickly or suddenly. Okay, so that case we will provide two package units and we will run duty standby, like per day 12 hour or weekly one package units. It's up to us. Okay, so we can decide how the package units running. Okay, so we can provide two package units and we can run duty standby based on. Okay, so we right now we have one control panel which will control two package units. Okay, so two package units with duty standby. Okay, so one will be working 12 hour, then the after 12 hour the another will start. So this will keep on working in cyclic mode. Okay, in case the working package units fails due to electrical fault or any mechanical fault, okay, the temperature goes the temperature is not reached or temperature goes higher than the set value, the standby package unit will take over and it will start cooling the area and it will maintain the cooling. Okay, so now we will see how the panel is working, how the panel has designed and how it will work. Okay, so how it will control the package units. So now we have one control panel. Okay, this is a package AC unit control panel. Okay, so this panel will control two ACs. Okay, so this is a fascia. On the fascia we have one thermostat or temperature controller and two AC sets. Okay, so each AC has run indication, trip indication and and off auto selector. The second AC also has the same. Okay, so when the AC runs, it will show the AC run indication. Any electrical faults, the trip indication will will indicate. We have selector, okay? So we have and off auto. And means the AC will run directly. Auto means the AC will run on timing basis. If any standby AC trips, duty AC trips, so that will take over. So it is in auto mode. Normally we have to keep both AC in auto mode, okay? If you put both in AND mode, so it will run together, two ACs. So we no need that one. So we will run the both AC in auto mode. So we will see internally. So this is AC internal part, okay? We have one common incomer. The main cable will come and it will feed the power supply to the individual AC. So each AC we have MCBs. Okay, so that will take care of the short circuit protection. And we have two contactor with overload relay. So for each AC we have one contactor and overload relay, okay? So whenever the duty AC signal has to come, or whichever the AC is duty, so that contactor will close, the power supply will feed to the AC, okay? Now we come to control parts. So here we have phase failure relay, okay? Phase failure relay that will protect this ACs from any phase fail or any low voltage, high voltage, okay? So this relay will sense it, it will trip the ACs from this faults, okay? So another one, we have 24 hour analog timer, okay? From this timer we will set the timing, okay? So our AC by what timing it should work, like 4 hour 4 hour or 6 hour 6 hour or 12 hour 12 hour, okay? We can set by selecting this timing, okay? And we have some auxiliary relay. So two auxiliary relay given for trip changeover, okay? And one auxiliary given for the high temperature, and one auxiliary relay given for the temperature cut in cut off, okay? So now, and some field wires. So this panel is interlocked with the fire alarm panel. So whenever the fire happens, so the panel if you connect the fire alarm cable, so the panel will trip if the fire alarm is activated. And also some control cables from the units, okay? So these units working in 24 volt AC. Normally most of HVAC system is working in 24 volt AC, okay? So we are not using we are not giving any external supply or from panel to the units to start up, okay? We are taking the individual inbuilt AC supply to our panel, and we will give back to as a command to start fan motor as well as the compressor, okay? For that we have given control terminals, okay? And we have some temperature controller, I already told you, and duct sensor or room sensor. You can keep this sensor in a return duct, or else you can keep somewhere in the cooling area also, okay? So this will sense the temperature, and that will give the feedback to the thermostat. The thermostat will decide the AC should start or stop, okay? Now we will give power to the panel and we will test, okay? Now we are not feeding any three-phase supply, we don't have source, okay? We will give only control supply, and we will test the operation only, how the system is working, how the panel is controlling the ACs. Now we have given the power to the panel, okay? So both selector switches off. Now we have bypassed the PFR, okay? Because there is no three-phase supply. If three-phase supply is not there, the PFR will not enable, so the panel is not working. The panel will not work. So I have given the bypassed control supply to check the operation only. Now both ACs in off mode. Now we will put AND mode. AC 1 is working. Second AND mode, both ACs are working in AND mode, okay? Now I will put in auto mode. Now the AC 1 is duty, okay? So now power is given to the AC for a start, start the blower and the compressor, the temperature controller has to enable, okay? So whenever the power is given to the AC units, the blower will start immediately, but the compressor will start based on the temperature and the command from the temperature controller, okay? So from temperature controller we are given the relay, okay? So I think now the relay is enabled. So now the command is given to the package unit 1. So the package 1 should start. If we have connected properly, the AC 1 will start, okay? So it will keep on run till the time changes, okay? If the timer changes, it will keep on change the duty standby, okay? Now AC 1 is working. Now AC 2 is working. So this will keep on working as per the timing, okay? In case now AC 2 is running, okay, if AC 2 is trips, so AC 1 will take over, okay? Now I have triggered the trip relay, so in practically AC 2 trips, the AC 2 will goes off, the AC 1 will work, okay? So this is the best solution for run two ACs with cyclically, okay, based on the timing, okay? So these two ACs will keep on working based on the time setting, okay? So one AC trips by electrical fault, so the second AC will take over, okay? If the AC is not tripped but it is failed to achieve the temperature, like AC is running but it is not able to achieve the temperature, so what will happen? The temperature sensor has the option, there we can do set the eye temperature also, okay? So once this room temperature goes beyond the set temperature of high temperature, so again it will trigger, it will send a signal and it will start the standby AC to achieve the setting, achieve the setting temperature, okay? So in package AC units, normally some AC is coming with the inbuilt thermostat, but most common ACs are not coming with the thermostat. It is coming with the provision of connecting the thermostat, okay? So these all ACs are package ACs are working in 24 volt AC supply. The 24 volt AC supply is inbuilt, available with the control panel, inbuilt with the units, okay? So we will take a 24 volt to our to panel. We will give back to the panel as a command to start blower, that means fan motor, also compressor, okay? So our panel, whenever the power supply enables, the same time the command will go to run the fan motor. First the blower power supply enables, then blower will start. If temperature demand is there, then the compressor start command will go, okay? If compressor command given, the compressor started, it will start the cooling the area. Once the set temperature reach, the temperature sensor will sense, it will give the signal to the controller. The controller will stop the compressor command. So only the compressor will cut off, okay? Then the same time the fan motor will be running and it will give the circulate the air from room of through return air duct and the through supply air duct and the return air duct, okay? After some time the temperature drops back again, the sensor will sense the same, it will give the signal to the controller, controller will start the compressor and the compressor will start again cooling till the set temperature, okay? So both package units will keep on working in timing basis, okay? So this is how the control panel will control the package unit, the package ACs will work in such a way, okay? So I hope you got an idea about package units and the package unit control panel, how you can how you want to control the package units, okay? Even you can control the individual, like if you don't want to run the duty standby, you can connect individual thermostat to individual unit and you can operate manually, okay? Even you can give command from SCADA or DDC controller, or even you can connect any external PLCs also, okay? Only the main concept is you have to make sure the package units are healthy, and you can give command to the particular units to start the fan motor, then the compressor. Okay, so you have to make sure when you are giving the compressor start command, the fan, the blower is working. Okay, so now we don't have option of monitoring the airflow. Okay, so how you make sure the fan is working, you have to monitor the airflow of the fan. Okay, so once the fans run, there will be airflow. Okay, so you have to provide one airflow switch and you have to monitor the airflow. Based on that, you can give the start command to the compressor. Okay, if you are running compressor without air, then there will be many issues that your HVAC people knows, or else we will see that part in next video. Okay, so thanks for watching. I hope you got an idea. Okay, so you are first time for my channel. If you like this video, please do subscribe, and I have posted many other videos related to HVAC, PLC, VFDs and electrical electronics, many subject, many related many topics related to HVAC electronics I have posted. Okay, so please do watch that. Okay, and subscribe. Okay, so we will meet in next video. Till then, bye from Sinappa.